Maybe I do sleep on a Dorito bed and I just, haven't made it, haven't shown anybody. I don't. It would be a lot crunchier, the sound right now, because I'm sitting on my bed. So it would be much crunchier if I was on a Dorito bed. And it would actually probably be pretty uncomfortable for a lot of reasons, but it's a good concept, really. Well, I think a Dorito bed would taste good until, you'd have to eat it very quickly after it was made, or at least the way that I'm imagining it, because it's just a, exactly though. Maybe it would actually, I think it would get more difficult to eat, but more comfortable to sleep on as you went on with a Dorito bed, right? Because day one, super crunchy, super powdery, right? And it's like, wow, I can't sleep on this, but this is delicious. And then day two, right, is a little bit stale, and it's like, these Doritos are, they're still kind of crispy. A lot of the, there's just a little bit of extra chewiness once they're in my mouth that's uncomfortable. Slightly more comfortable to lay on, right? Then you get a week or two going past. Those Doritos are nice and smushy, right? And you can get a wonderful sleep on top of these Doritos, and all the powder would probably be off because the ants came and collected it or whatever. I think the Dorito bed, it depends on what you want it for, right? If you want it for a snack, it is a great short-term investment. If you want it for a bed, it's a admittedly really terrible long-term investment, but it does get better as the time goes on, unlike anything else, you know? That's how I view it. I think you got to go raw Doritos for the bed itself, and then you just take a full bag of Doritos as the pillow. And the excellent thing about that, right, is that if you have the bag as the pillow, you don't have nearly as many Doritos the next day, but you still have perfect condition Doritos for quite a while, as long as you're careful about the position you sleep in. I mean, you don't pop the bag. Yeah, washed out. I mean, I guess op if we're going to talk realistically, the optimal Dorito bed would probably be to take the bags, wash them out very thoroughly, and pack them together in a way. You'd probably want to put some cotton in there and stuff too, so it actually got a little bit of bounce to it. But we're taught the bed has to be made out of Doritos in my hypothetical situation, as far as I'm concerned. If it's not, you're doing it wrong. I think a Mountain Dew bed. Well, I guess it would be like a water bed. So you pretty much take a water bed, but you fill it with Mountain Dew, which, I mean, similar to the Dorito bed idea. No, actually, it's kind of almost the reversal. That would get just really sticky and gross after a few days. A Mountain Dew bed would be. It would be exactly the same as a water bed, and it would be totally fine for one day, and then it would become an extreme problem. Yeah, I guess you'd have to use the bottles if we wanted to go completely and totally Mountain Dew. You actually might want to use the paper around the outside of the bottle, probably. Try to replicate the material of an actual water bed the best you can, kind of like a balloony type of thing, but yeah, and then you just fill it up with Mountain Dew, and then you really hope that you don't pop it. Yeah, after not very long at all, I would think a Mountain Dew bed would be pretty bad. But I think the Dorito bed's actually worse.